Well, earlier this week, British Labour's Ed Miliband became the first party leader to call for an independent review of Britain's press following the revelations of phone hacking by the tabloid News of the World. The paper has now admitted it was involved in hacking and it's apologised, but police believe the practice may be much more widespread than first thought, with possibly hundreds of people affected. Already this story has seen the imprisonment of the News of the World's former royal editor, Clive Goodman, and a private investigator, Glenn Mulcair. It also led to the resignation of Prime Minister David Campbell's press secretary, Andy Coulson, a former editor. Well, to discuss the evolving story, we're joined in London by Roy Greenslade. He's a professor of journalism at City University London, a columnist with The Guardian, and a former editor of the Daily Mirror. Thanks for being there, Roy.
Hi.
Let's start with some basics. Who is Glenn Mulcair and why was he employed by the News of the World in the first place?
Mr. Mulcair is a former footballer who turned himself into a private investigator in his after his career stopped kicking the ball. And he made a habit of obtaining information which was difficult for people normally to get hold of, probably involving police information which is not readily available even to journalists who cultivate the police. So he was viewed within the News of the World, which put him on a contract for £100,000 a year. He was viewed as an essential part, really, para staff, as it were, in order to obtain information on behalf of the reporters.
Now, one of the puzzling aspects of this is that the original police investigation only turned up evidence that about a dozen victims had been hacked in the operation. There's now a second investigation and seems to suggest that possibly hundreds have been hacked. Why was this missed by the police first time around?
Well, we don't know. That's part of the mystery. And part of the reason that this story has lasted for 5 years. The royal editor you mentioned and Mr. Mulcair went to jail in 2006. And it's taken that long for this story to unravel. And I think the oddity is that we know the police originally found in Mr. Mulcair's home many notes, many documents containing possibly 3,000 names. We're not quite certain, but certainly hundreds of names of celebrities, politicians, agents, PR agents and so on, and also a number of PIN numbers, the numbers to their cell phones. And unfortunately, the police decided in their wisdom that they were only going to proceed with the cases involving Prince William and Prince Harry. The reasons for that have yet to emerge, but there has been a suggestion that there was a misunderstanding between the police investigators and the prosecution services, in which the police misunderstood some advice from the Crown Prosecution Service. This has led to a row between the Crown Prosecution Service and the Metropolitan Police, which itself at the moment is unresolved, but is part of the reason that the police are now investigating the police and reinvestigating the whole aspect of phone hacking at the News of the World.
It's all very odd. Now, this private investigator, Mulcair, has racked up hundreds of thousands of pounds in legal fees. Is it clear whether the Murdoch empire is actually paying for his defence?
There is a supposition that the organisation is paying, but they won't say yes and they won't say no. And I've been carrying questions about that on my blog, and I'll be carrying yet another one tomorrow. We find it very baffling that they haven't denied it, but they also haven't admitted it. And we're going to put his lawyers under pressure to explain exactly who is paying, what will amount to enormous costs. If they are paying, I ought to say it's extraordinary. This man has been convicted of intercepting voicemail messages. He has served months in jail. And the idea that in such circumstances, one of the world's most powerful media organisations, which is, after all, about supposedly holding power to account, if it was paying, it would be, I think, a desperate situation and something to deplore.
Is it clear, or is it becoming clear yet, who in the newspaper gave him his riding instructions and whether or not he was acting on direct instructions when he began to break the law in this hacking operation?
Again, we don't clearly know. What we do know is that clearly two journalists did give him instructions, one of whom has